Hello viewers, my name is Dr. Ajay, Associate Professor from the Department of BCE, IRE Engineering College, Hyderabad. Today, we are going to discuss about the folded dipole antenna and its input impedance. Today's topic in our course, Antennas, Waves and Propagation is folded dipole antenna and the input impedance. So here, let us discuss about the, in this session about folded dipole antenna. The folded dipole antenna, it consists of a basic dipole but with an added conductor connecting the two ends together. This makes a loop of wire, that is a short circuit to DC. As the ends appear to be folded back, the antenna is called as the folded dipole antenna. So here, a folded dipole antenna, it is basically designed from the basic half wave dipole antenna. It means that if you take a half wave dipole antenna, the half wave dipole antenna will appear like this. And if you attach a conductor in parallel to this half wave dipole antenna, the total wire or the total antenna, we call it as a folded dipole antenna. It means if you put a conductor in parallel to this half wave dipole antenna, and if you connect these two ends, the figure shown on the display is which is nothing but it is a folded dipole antenna. So basically, this folded dipole antenna, it is one form of a half wave dipole antenna, where the radiation pattern of a half wave dipole antenna, it is similar to the folded dipole antenna. So here, a folded dipole antenna is also having the same radiation characteristics, the same radiation pattern as a half wave dipole antenna. So one of the major application in the folded dipole antenna is, so in every Yagi Uda antenna, we use a folded dipole antenna. As we have seen in the earlier session, we have discussed about the Yagi Uda antenna. In Yagi Uda antenna, there is a driven element, there is a reflector, and there is a director. So out of these three elements, one element, the driven element, is taken as a folded dipole antenna. One element, that is a driven element, in the Yagi Uda antenna, we consider only the folded dipole antenna in designing the Yagi Uda antenna. So here, basically the folded dipole antenna, it consists of a basic dipole antenna. So this portion from here to here, this portion we call it as a folded dipole antenna. Here we are going to add another conductor. You can see here, this is known as the additional conductor here. And these two ends are connected together here. These two ends are connected at the two ends together. So if we connect these two ends of half a dipole with another conductor, this will form a loop antenna. This is in the shape of a loop. This is the loop of the wire, that is a short circuit to DC. So here you can see here these ends are appearing to be folded back here. Hence, this antenna, we call it as a folded dipole antenna. And also, we need to excite this antenna. That means we need to give some input signal to the antenna. So this is known as a transmission line here. This is known as a feeding line or the feeding section. This is known as the feeding line, we call it as. Or basically, we can also use a transmission line. We can also use a balanced transmission line. And moreover, whenever we design this folded dipole antenna, the radiation characteristics, it depends upon the radius of the wire. It depends upon the radius of the two wires. That means here there are two wires. One is, this is R1 and this is R2. The radiation efficiency and the radiation characteristics will vary depending upon the spacing between the two conductors, and also it depends upon the radius of the two conductors. So here, the balanced transmission line has to be given as a feeding to the folded dipole antenna. This is known as the balanced transmission line. This balanced transmission line has to be given as the input feeding line to the folded dipole antenna. Like the basic dipole, the folded dipole antenna, it is a balanced antenna and needs to be fed with a balanced feeder. So here, the balanced feeder means the input impedance of the transmission line must be equivalent to the input impedance of the antenna. That means the input impedance of the transmission line must be equivalent to the input impedance of the terminals of the antenna. That means if you want to equal, if you want to match the impedance of the transmission line with respect to the antenna, so you need to use a balanced transmission line. Suppose if you say here, if this is the transmission line, if this transmission line, the impedance of the transmission line is 75 ohms, see that the antenna impedance is also must be 75 ohms only. This is known as a balanced feeder. Right? If there is only matching between the input impedance of the antenna and the impedance of the transmission line, then only the radiation efficiency can be increased. Then only the radiation characteristics can be increased. See that whenever you give the input, if the input signal given to the folded dipole antenna is 100 ohms. That is the transmission line input impedance is 100 ohms, and if the antenna impedance is only 75 ohms, there is a mismatch between the impedance. There is the mismatch between the antenna impedance and also the balanced line and also the transmission line impedance. If there is any mismatch between the impedance of the antenna and the impedance of the transmission line, then the radiation efficiency will decrease. Then the radiation efficiency of the folded dipole antenna will decrease. If the radiation efficiency decreases, then the bandwidth also reduces. The additional part of the folded dipole antenna is often made by using a wire or a rod of same diameter as a basic dipole section. Here, whenever we are going to design a half wave dipole antenna, if this is a half wave dipole antenna, suppose, and this portion we call it as the diameter, the end portion we call it as the diameter of the wire, or we can also call it as a radiator of the wire. So whenever you are going to attach another wire to this half wave dipole antenna, see that the diameter of this portion, let us assume this as 1, the diameter of this portion 1 must be equivalent to the diameter of this wire, which is folded at the two ends. So whenever we are going to design a folded dipole antenna, we should take some observation. We should carefully design in such a way that the diameter of the half wave dipole antenna must be equivalent to the diameter of the wire which we are going to attach to the half wave dipole antenna. So the basic dipole section, this is the basic dipole section here. This is made up of a wire, it can also be designed by means of a rod also. And this rod diameter must be equivalent to the second conductor which we are going to attach to the half wave dipole antenna. Also, the wires or rods are typically equally spaced along the length of the parallel elements. That means element is nothing but it is also a conductor, it is also an antenna. So whenever you take an half wave dipole antenna, which is in parallel to this half wave dipole antenna, we call it as an element. And whenever you can also place any number of elements, there is only one element placed in parallel to the half wave dipole antenna, we can also place another type of antenna in parallel to this half wave dipole antenna. And whenever we are going to increase the number of elements and attach the ends of the elements with respect to the half wave dipole antenna, see that the spacing here, if this spacing is A and if this spacing is B, the spacing must be equal. The spacing between the elements must be equal. So you can also keep any number of elements in parallel to this half wave dipole antenna. You can place any number of elements in parallel to this half wave dipole antenna. And whenever we are going to place all these elements in parallel, see that the spacing between the elements must be equal. equispaced. So equispaced means the length of the width, the spacing between the elements must be equal. So these are the basic characteristics of the folded dipole, and these are some basics of the folded dipole antenna. So before we are going to start the design, if the conductors in the main dipole and the second are fold conductor of the same diameter, then it is found that there is a four-fold increase, that is 2 squared in the field impedance. That means whenever if you take an half-wave dipole antenna, whenever if you take a folded dipole antenna, we know that the radiation resistance of the fold, the radiation resistance of an half-wave dipole antenna is 73 ohms. This is an half-wave dipole antenna. We know that from our previous sessions, we have derived earlier the expression for the radiation resistance of the half-wave dipole antenna is 73 ohms. We know that the radiation resistance of a current element is 80 pi square dl by lambda whole square. From that derivation, 80 pi square into dl by lambda whole square, we have derived one expression based upon that derivation, 80 pi square dl by lambda whole square. The derivation for the radiation resistance to find out the radiation resistance of half wave dipole antenna is 73 ohms. So when we attach any conductor in parallel to this half wave dipole antenna, and if you join these two ends, then the radiation resistance of this folded dipole antenna will increase from 73 ohms to 300 ohms. That means the input impedance of the folded dipole antenna is increasing 2 square. That means 73 into 2 square. 4. 4 3s are 12, 4 7s are 28, 29. So 292 ohms. So 292 ohms it is increased. This is approximately equal to 300 ohms. This is rounded off to 300 ohms. Right. So here, whenever we attach a conductor to this half wave dipole antenna, the input impedance or the radiation resistance increases from the 73 ohms to the 300 ohms. It means that the input impedance has been increased here 2 squared. 2 squared means it is, you can take it as n square. So as you increase the number of elements, in parallel to the folded dipole antenna, the feed impedance will increase. If there are three conductors in parallel, you can see here. Suppose if there are three conductors for this half-wave dipole antenna. Suppose if this is an half-wave dipole antenna, we are attaching one line and we are attaching another line. Right? So these two ends are joined together here. Here, this is n cubed. There are three lines. Totally, there are three elements. So, it is n cubed. So, this is nothing but 3 square. It is increased by n square. So, 3 square means 9. So, 9 into 73. So, 9 3s are 27. 7 into 2, 9 7 is 63. 65. So, whenever you place another element in parallel, if you place this is one element in parallel, and this is another element. This is 1 and this is 2. There are two elements in parallel to this half-wave dipole antenna. So then the input impedance will increase to 657 ohms. That means n square, 73 into n square. So like this, the input impedance of the folded dipole antenna can be increased by increasing the number of elements in parallel to this half-wave dipole antenna by connecting the ends. Half-wave dipole antenna to this conductors. So this is one of the basic advantages of the folded dipole antenna. So the half-wave dipole antenna, it is only 73 ohms, the input impedance, and it has been increased to 292 ohms. By connecting another conductor in parallel to this half-wave dipole antenna. So here you can observe here a folded dipole antenna, it is formed by joining two half-wave dipole at both the ends and splitting one of them in the middle. So here the split dipole is fed at the center by a balanced transmission line. So here there are two types of transmission lines you can observe in the figure here. This is known as one dipole. This dipole, we call it as a continuous dipole. This is known as the continuous dipole, and this is known as the split dipole. This is known as the split dipole. So here, there are two types of dipoles in the foldable dipole antenna. One is a split dipole, the other one is the continuous dipole. So this one is the continuous dipole and this one is the split dipole. And you can observe here the radii from A to B, this radii is equivalent to this radii. The radii from A to B, that is the diameter of the conductor from A to B, will be equivalent to the diameter from this portion also, from the above portion of the AB. And moreover, the radiation pattern is bidirectional. The radiation pattern of the half-wave dipole antenna and the radiation pattern of the foldable dipole antenna will be bidirectional. So it will be in the figure of 8. It will be in the figure of 8. And here, whenever a current is passed, this is known as a balanced transmission line. Generally, we take a coaxial cable as a balanced transmission line. So the transmission line which we use, the most popular transmission line is the coaxial cable. It is attached at the ends of the foldable dipole antenna. That means the coaxial cable, it consists of two conductors. One is the inner conductor. So one is the inner conductor here. There is another conductor here. This is known as external conductor and this is known as the internal conductor. And this internal conductor is given to the one conductor of the half-wave dipole antenna and the external conductor is given to the another terminal of the half-wave dipole antenna. This is connected to one terminal and this is connected, external is connected to the other terminal of the half-wave dipole antenna. And here, whenever we give some input signal, here, to this transmission line, this input current passes through this through the conductors via A and via B. And here, what happens is at the sections of A and B, this input current is split. That is, the input current is divided into half. That means, in this dipole antenna, half current will flow. In this conductor, half of the current will flow. That means the current is divided equally. Only when the diameter of the radii are equal. Only when the diameter of the radii of this conductor, of the two conductors, here there are two conductors. This portion is one conductor and this is another conductor. Only if the radii of the two conductors are same, then only the currents passed will be in the two dipoles will be divided equally, the equal currents will form in the two conductors. That means I by 2 current will flow across this conductor AB and the other portion also I by 2 current will flow, a uniform I by 2 current will flow. Right? You can observe here in the display here, D1, here D1 represents the diameter of this conductor, here D2 represents the diameter of this conductor. Here the diameter of the two conductors are same, that is D1 will be equal to D2. Only if D1 is equal to D2, then only the current will be divided equally. In first conductor and in the second conductor. Right? So the total wavelength here in this portion, this is one half-wave dipole antenna and this is one half-wave dipole antenna. The total length is given as lambda by 2. The length of the, here there are, as there are two half-wave dipole antennas. Here, this is one half-wave dipole antenna and this is another half-wave dipole antenna. Here, the length of this half-wave dipole antenna is lambda by 2. This configuration is essentially two dipoles in parallel and therefore has the same voltages at the ends. Here, there are two dipoles in parallel. So, as we observed here, this is one dipole and there is one dipole here and here there is another dipole here. Right? So, these two dipoles are in parallel and therefore have the same voltages at the two ends. The radiation pattern is same as that of a single dipole, but the input impedance is here. Right? So, for a half-wave dipole antenna, the radiation pattern will be like this. And even if you take an half-wave dipole antenna, the radiation pattern is same. So you can observe here in the figure, you take an half-wave dipole antenna here, the half-wave dipole antenna will appear like this. And if you take a folded dipole antenna, the input impedance is higher. As input impedance is higher, the radiation efficiency increases. So here, you can see here for half-wave dipole antenna, the radiation pattern is very small. For the folded dipole antenna, the input impedance is higher, hence the radiation pattern produced by this folded dipole antenna is very high compared to the half-wave dipole antenna. Since the circuit in the two dipoles is half of that in a single dipole antenna and the radiated power is the same, it follows that the input impedance is 4 times that of a single dipole. That means here the circuit in the two dipoles is half. As you are giving the input signal, that input signal is being shared to the two dipoles equally. That means the two dipoles is half of that in a single dipole antenna and the radiated power will be the same. And the radiated power by the two dipoles will be same. Why? Because the current is being shared equally among the two conductors. Here if this is current I by 2, here there will be the current I by 2. As the current is being shared equally between the two conductors, the power radiated by this element will be equal to the radiated power radiated by this element. Right? The radiated power, it is same. And it follows that the input impedance is 4 times that of a single dipole. It follows that the input impedance is 4 times that of a single dipole. So due to this reason, as the current is being split equally among the two conductors, the radiation characteristics, the radiation efficiency increases. That means the input impedance is increasing, the radiation efficiency will also be increased. Here, the input impedance or the radiation resistance for a dipole is around 73 ohms. Here the dipole is nothing but a half wave dipole antenna. For an half wave dipole antenna, the input impedance or the radiation resistance is taken as 73 ohms. Hence, for the folded dipole with two arms, the radiation resistance will be 4 into 73. 4 into 73 is equal to 292 ohms. That means RR into N square. The formula to find out the input impedance of a folded dipole antenna is RR into N square. This RR represents the radiation resistance of a half-wave dipole antenna. The radiation resistance of an half-wave dipole antenna is 73 into N square. That means 2 square. So you can say here, this is one element and this is one element. So here totally, there is 1, this is 2. Right, so for this you will get 292 ohms. So for this type of first design, that means if there are two elements, then the radiation resistance will be increased to 292 ohms. For this element only, if there is single element, it is 73 ohms. For single element, it is 73 ohms. If this is half a dipole antenna, this is the radiation resistance is 73 ohms. If you attach one wire to this, the radiation resistance increases to 292 ohms. And if you attach another wire here there is 1 and this is 2, here 1, this is 2 and this is 3. This is known as a tripole. This is known as a tripole antenna. So for this case, the input impedance will be RR into N square. So here N represents the number of conductors. Here RR means it is 73 into, here there are 3 elements, it is 3 square. 73 into 3 square, that means it is equivalent to 657 ohms. Right? So here, you can observe here, as the number of conductors have been increased and if the spacing is same and if the diameter of the conductors is same, then the input impedance increases. Then the input impedance increases by a factor of N square. Then the input increases by a factor of N square, right? So the antenna works satisfactorily over a broad band of frequencies. It is used for a television reception along with the same parasitic elements. So for a broadband of frequencies at a very high frequency range, this folded dipole antenna is used. And this folded dipole antenna, it is most popular in a Yagi-Uda antenna. So as we have known that an Yagi-Uda antenna, it will be like this. This is an Yagi-Uda antenna. And this is a reflector. This is a director. This is another director. So this is an Aggie antenna. This is known as a driven element. This is driven element, which is taken as a folded dipole antenna. Which is taken as the folded dipole antenna. And this is the reflector. This is the reflector. And this is the director. This is the director. And this is D2, another director. This is D2, another director. Right? So this is the driven element and this is the folded dipole antenna. So which is most popular, which is used in the Yagi Uda antenna? It is used for television reception. So for television reception, this is one of the famous antenna which we are going to use, along with some parasitic elements. So these reflector antenna and these two elements are known as parasitic elements. So here, why these elements are known as parasitic? So here you can observe, here in this type of antenna, we are giving the input signal only to the driven element. You can observe here, if this is 1, if this is 2, if this is 3, and if this is 4th element. So here there are totally 4 elements. You can observe in these 4 elements, 1, 2, 3 and 4, we are giving the input signal only to the driven element. We are giving only to the driven element, that is folded dipole element. Hence the element 1, we call it as an active element. Hence element 1, we are giving the input signal to the element 1, we can specify it as an active element. The other 3 elements, 2, 3 and 4, we are not giving the input signal. When we give the input signal to the element 1, some magnetic field is induced to the elements of 2 and 3. To the elements of reflector and to the elements of 3, some magnetic field is induced. Due to this magnetic field, some electric field also gets induced in the element 3. That means 3 and 4 and 2, 2, 3 and 4 elements are getting the electric field not directly but indirectly. As they are getting the current, as the amount of electric field is induced in the elements 2, 3 and 4 in an indirect method, these elements are known as parasitic elements. They are not giving the input signal directly. The two elements 2, 3 and 4 we are not giving the input signal directly. They are absorbing some amount of energy from the element 1, some voltage is induced in the element 3, and from the 3, the voltage is induced to the element 4. So like this, the electric field is induced in the elements 3, 4 and 2. Right? That means 2, 3 and 4 are not given supply directly. Hence, these elements are known as the parasitic elements. So this is the basic design of a folded dipole antenna. So this is a lambda by 2 length. The length of the half wave dipole antenna, it is taken as a lambda by 2. So this is known as a 2 wire folded dipole antenna. Here there are only 2 wires. This is one wire and this is another wire, 1 and 2. So as there are 2 wires, we call it as a 2 wire folded dipole antenna. So if you modify the in the form of circuit, the same folded dipole antenna, it will appear like this. That means the voltage is being shared equally along the two conductors. This is 1 and this is 2. You can observe here, the voltage is given here at the input signal. This voltage is being shared among the two conductors equally as V by 2. And let us assume the spacing between the conductors is D. Let us assume the spacing between the two conductors is D. So this is the basic structure of a 3-wired folded dipole antenna. You can see here, 3-wire folded dipole antenna. There are 3 wires. This is 1, this is 2, and this is 3. Right? So there are 3 folded dipole antenna. As there are 3 folded, we can say this as 73 into n square, 73 into 3 square. This is equal to 657 ohms is the input impedance of this 3-wire folded dipole antenna. Let us assume this V be the EMF applied to the antenna terminals. Here there is a V here. Let us assume that V is the EMF applied at the antenna terminals and A dash, which is being equally divided in each dipole. So here, if you observe here, if this is an half wave dipole antenna, let us assume this as A and A dash. So at A dash, this V which is applied here, it is equally divided in each dipole. let us assume V is the EMF applied here, and at A and A dash, the voltage which we supply, it is being divided equally among the two wires. This is 1 and this is 2. The voltage in each dipole is V by 2. So, on by nodal analysis, we can write as V by 2 is equal to I1 Z11 plus I2 Z12. So, you can observe here, the current is shared, the current is divided half as the voltage is V. The current can be divided as here as I by 2 and here as I by 2, right? So, here I by 2 is equal to, we can write in the form of a nodal analysis, you can see here, sorry, V by 2 is equal to, you can see here, the voltage is shared, that is the voltage induced is given as V, the voltage is shared, V by 2 is equal to I1 Z11 plus I1 Z12, I1 Z, I2 Z12, I2 Z12. So, here let us assume the current flowing in the conductor 1 is I1. So, every conductor, when some voltage is given, it will be having some self impedance. It will be having some self impedance. That self impedance we call it as Z11. So, Z11 indicates the self impedance of conductor 1, and Z12 indicates the mutual impedance between the conductors 1 and 2. Let us assume Z12 as the mutual impedance between the conductors 1 and 2. And Z11 is the self impedance of 1. So, by applying nodal analysis, we can write V by 2 is equal to I1 Z11 plus I2 Z12. Right? So, but I1 is equal to I2. Right? The same current is flowing across the two conductors. So, this I2 is equal to I1. So, you can write this equation as V by 2 is equal to I1 into Z11 plus Z12. So, V by 2 is equal to I1 into Z11 plus Z12. And here, the two dipoles in the system are very close to each other. The spacing A between the two dipoles is of the order of lambda by 100, right? So, if we assume the spacing is as A, and if this A is very less, if this A, that is the spacing between the two dipoles is very less, assume as lambda by 100, then in that case, this mutual impedance and the self impedance will be equal. The mutual impedance and the self impedance will be equal. That is, Z11 will be equal to Z12. So, if you substitute this Z11 is equal to Z12 in this equation, you will get V by 2 is equal to I1 into Z11 plus Z11. So, this is equal to I1 into 2 Z11. This is equal to V by 2. Right? So, you will get V by I1 is equal to 4 Z11. So, V by I1 is equal to 4 Z11. So, V by I1 is nothing but the input impedance Z in can be written. We can write as Z in, the input impedance. This is equal to Z11 into 4. Z11 into 4. So, Z11 is nothing but the self impedance of conductor. The self impedance of the conductor 1 is nothing but the half-wave dipole antenna. It is 73 ohms. It is 73 ohms into 4 is equal to 292 ohms. It is known as a 292 ohms. So, this is how we get the input impedance of the folded dipole antenna. Folded dipole antenna 73 into 4 is equal to 292 ohms. So, we can increase by increasing the number of wires. Put 7, so, this is 73 into 4. This is nothing but we can write as this can be generalized as n square. 73 into 4, it can be generalized as 73 into n square. So, 73, if you increase the number of conductors, n is equal to 3, then it becomes 73 into 3 square, it is equal to 657 ohms. That means the input impedance is being increased to 657 ohms. So, this is the case of three wire folded dipole antenna. So, similarly, as we have derived earlier, so V1 by 3 is equal to Z11 here. For this, there will be some self-impedance Z11 here. And for this, between these two, between 1 and 2, this is mutual impedance between 1 and 2. That is, Z12 indicates the mutual impedance between 1 and 2. And this Z13, this is the mutual impedance between 1 and 3. Between 1 and 3. So, as the radius of these conductors is same, the current will be uniform flowing across the three conductors, across the three elements. Hence, I1 is equal to I2 is equal to I3, right? As if we as I1 is equal to I2 is equal to I3, and if we assume that the distance, the spacing between the elements, the spacing between the elements 1 and 2 and between the elements 2 and 3, if it is very less, if it is far less than lambda by 100, if the spacing between the elements is very less, like lambda by 100, then Z11 is equal to Z12 is equal to Z13, right? So, if you substitute this equivalent, you will get here, in this expression, if you substitute here, if you substitute this, all these things here, you will get V1 by 3 is equal to Z11 plus Z11 plus Z11 into I1. You will get V1 by I1 is equal to 3 into 3 Z11. Right? So, this is equal to 9 Z11. This is equal to 9 Z11. So, V1 by I1 is equal to, we will get Z1, the input impedance. This is equal to 9 into the input impedance. The self impedance is 73 ohms. The self impedance of the half wave dipole antenna is 73 ohms, which is equivalent to 657 ohms. So, for a 3 wired polar dipole antenna, the input impedance has been increased from 73 ohms to 657 ohms. For a half wave dipole antenna, it is 73 ohms. For a tripole or a 3 wired polar dipole antenna, it has been increased to 657 ohms. So, we can write, this can be generalized as V1 by I1 is equal to 9 into Z11, and this can be written as N square into Z11, N square into Z11. Here, N is equal to 3 conductors. That means 3 square into 73, 3 square into 73. This is equal to 657 ohms, 657 ohms. The self-impedance of half a dipole antenna is nothing but the radiation resistance, which is 73 ohms. So, this is the generalized Z is equal to N square into 73. For unequal radii of two dipoles, the input impedance is written as. So, in the previous case, we have seen that the radius of the two dipoles or the three dipoles is same. But if the radius of the conductors, which we use for a polar dipole antenna, are not similar, then the Z can be written as, the input impedance can be written as Z11 into 1 plus R2 by R1 whole square plus is equal to 73. This is 73 represents the half wave dipole antenna radiation resistance. 73 into 1 plus R2 by R1 whole square. So, R1 represents the radius of dipole 1 and R2 represents the radius of dipole 2. So, if we, let us assume that R2 is equal to 2 R1. Suppose if we substitute here, R2 is equal to 2 R1 here. Right. So, you will get 73 into 1 plus 2 R1 by R1 whole square. R1 will get cancelled. So, 73 into 3 square. This is equal to 657 ohms. This is equal to 657 ohms under this assumption. That means, if the radius of the second conductor is equivalent to twice that of the radius of the first conductor, then in that case, the input impedance is 657 ohms. Also, the impedance transformation not only depends upon the relative radius of the conductors, but also on the relative relative spacing. That means the sometimes the impedance, the input impedance will vary depending upon the spacing, not only on the radius. So, in the previous case, we assumed that the radius of the two conductors is same, right? The input impedance not only depends upon the, radius of the two conductors, but also on the relative spacing. That means, if you say here, if this is one conductor, conductor one half wave dipole antenna, and this is another conductor here. This radius is R1 and this radius is R2. And if this spacing is A, if this spacing between the conductors is assumed as A, in that case, Z is can be written as Z11 into 1 plus log A by R1 by log A by R2 whole square. So, under if the radius of the two conductors are different and the spacing is A, in that case, Z is equal to Z11 into 1 plus log A by R1 by log A by R2 whole square. And here, Z by Z11 is known as impedance transformation ratio, which is denoted by symbol ITR. So, ITR represents the impedance transformation ratio. The impedance transformation ratio, it is given by ITR is equal to 1 plus log A by R1 by log a by 2 r by r 2 whole square is equal to z r. So we can write this ITR as z r simply, impedance transformation ratio. So this impedance transformation, the significance of impedance transformation ratio is nothing but the impedance of the folded double antenna will vary if the spacing between the elements is dissimilar, if the spacing between the conductors is not same. Suppose if you take a three wire dipole antenna, suppose this is one and this is two, here there are three elements, right? So though the radius are different, here the radius are different, here this is R1, this is R2 and this is R3, and this is the spacing A and this is spacing A. And see that the spacing between the elements must be same when you design a folded dipole antenna, even if the radius of the conductors is dissimilar, it's not the same, right? So in this case, the impedance will vary. So in this case, as the radius is different, the impedance will vary. So in the impedance transformation ratio, it is given by 1 plus log A by R1 by log A by R2 whole square. The advantages of folded dipole antenna, it is the reception of balanced signals. So this is best suited for receiving applications only. So it receives a particular signal from a band of frequencies without losing the quality. So most of the frequencies it will receive, the performance of the folded dipole antenna is good in terms of receiving the signal without losing the quality. The folded dipole maximizes the signal strength. So as you increase the number of elements in parallel to the half-wave dipole antenna, more amount of energy can be absorbed to the folded dipole antenna. That means if the more amount of energy is absorbed, then the signal strength will increase. That means the electric field strength induced to the folded dipole antenna increases. And disadvantages of the folded dipole antenna, the displacement and adjustment of the antenna is a hassle. That means sometimes whenever during heavy rainfall, this folded dipole antenna will move with a small variation in a small deviation of some angle. That means if you take a folded dipole antenna, if this is a Yagi antenna, this is a folded dipole antenna, this is a reflector antenna, and if this is the director antenna, there will be a single rod here. All these elements are attached to this axis. This is axis of the rod here. So whenever during heavy rainfall, this axis will move slightly in a different direction. Whenever during heavy rainfall. That means again, to receive the signal, to improve the signal strength, this has to be fixed every time when there is a rainfall. So whenever there is a rainfall, the angle of the elevation or the angle where we fixed the antenna, it will slightly deviate. That means this has to be displaced whenever there is a rainfall. There will be a small displacement in the folded dipole antenna where we placed in the location, right? So we need to adjust the antenna again to maximize the signal strength. So outdoor management can be difficult when antenna size increases. So as the number of elements increases, it's not an easy way to carry to longer distances. As the antenna size is increased with the number of elements, though the radiation efficiency increases, but it's very difficult for us to carry this folded dipole antenna to longer distances. So it is mainly used as a feeder element in a Yagi antenna, in a parabolic antenna, in a turnstile antenna, in a log periodic antenna, in phase and reflector antennas. So these are the main applications of folded dipole antenna where we use. So mainly in a Yagi antenna as a feeder element, we use this folded dipole antenna. Also, we can also use as a feeder element in a parabolic reflector antenna. So we can also use this folded element as a folded antenna, as a turnstile antenna, in a log periodic antenna, in a phase and a reflected arrays also, we can use this folded dipole antenna. So most cases, in most of the applications we use, it is best suited for receiving applications only. Generally used in radio receivers and a TV receiver antennas. So most commonly used in the TV receiver antennas. So generally used in the radio receivers. So this is about the folded dipole antenna. So let us conclude this folded dipole antenna. A folded dipole antenna is nothing but a half-wave dipole antenna where another conductor is placed in parallel and is connected to the two ends of the half wave dipole antenna. This configuration we call it as a folded dipole antenna. So one of the major advantages of this folded dipole antenna is we can increase the input impedance of the folded dipole antenna. So basically, half wave dipole antenna radiation resistance is 73 ohms and its radiation resistance can be multiplied into n square. The radiation resistance can be increased by a factor of n square, where n is the number of elements or the number of conductors which are placed in parallel to the half wave dipole antenna. So one of the major application which we use this folded dipole antenna is it is best suited for receiving applications in radio receivers and TV receiving applications, TV receiver antennas. So as you increase the number of elements in parallel to the half wave dipole antenna and connect all the ends together, the radiation efficiency will be increased. So whenever we design a folded dipole antenna, see that the spacing between the elements must be same, and also the diameter of the conductors which we are going to attach to the ends of the half wave dipole antenna. So all the diameters must be same. So whenever the diameter is same and the spacing is same, then the radiation efficiency can be increased and it will be uniform. And we can maximize the signal strength by increasing the number of wires connected in parallel to the ends of the half wave dipole antenna. Thank you.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.